Today, Apple is the biggest company in the world at a market capitalization of $2 trillion. This means you would need to pay $2 trillion to buy the entire company, which implies that even the richest person in the world, Jeff Bezos, could only buy a 10% stake if he used his entire net worth. It is not widely known, but before Apple released the iPod and later the iPhone, the MacBook and more, the company was struggling badly. Until the very last months of 2004, the stock of Apple was worth just $1. Right now, it is worth exactly $120. I am not a mathematician, but a 120 times gain in 16 years sounds pretty good. However, before this meteoric rise, the company was struggling hard at a number of different times. Apple went public in 1980, and for the 24 years until 2004, its stock price kept fluctuating between 0.1 and 1. Its products were never really widely successful, and most of this time the company was close to bankruptcy. Let us present you with a series about the top 10 company turnaround stories. In this series, we will take one company per video and explain how close they were to failure, and then tell you how they beat the looming doom. If you are currently struggling, as many of us are in these hard times, feel free to take this as a motivation for your own life. If you like the video, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and push the bell button so that you can see future videos. We will keep uploading videos about educating and interesting stories concerning the world's richest people and companies. Alright, let's start. Apple was founded by Steve Jobs, Steve Wozniak and Ronald Rain in April 1976 to develop and sell Wozniak's Apple I personal computer. Wayne sold his share in the company within only 12 days. 1 year later, in 1977, sales of computers, including the Apple II, grew quickly. Apple finally went public in 1980 and presented the original Macintosh in 1984. However, after a small initial success, the high price of Apple's products and power struggles between the different executives caused a number of problems. In 1985, Wozniak departed Apple and remained an honorary employee, while Jobs and others resigned to found Next, a competitor. The market for personal computers expanded rapidly through the 1990s and Apple lost market share to the lower priced Microsoft. Apple even sued Microsoft for copyright infringement in 1988, but unfortunately for Apple, the case was lost in 1989. After a number of appeals, the legal battle finally ended in 1995, when the Supreme Court denied Apple's petition. In 1989, Apple unveiled a new portable computer, the Macintosh Portable. It was Apple's first battery-powered Mac. Unfortunately, it was a huge disaster due to its low battery life, its high price and its heavy weight. Also in 1993, another product failed to succeed, the Newton Message Pad, which was a PDA. A PDA is basically the first version of a very clumsy attempt of a smartphone. Due to its lousy handwriting recognition, the Newton Message Pad disappointed the market. In 1994, the board finally recruited CEO Jill Amelio, who was known as a turnaround artist. He bought Jobs' company Next in 1997 and solved the desperately failed operating system strategy. During Amelio's reign at the top, Apple suffered a loss of $1.6 billion, with Apple being on the verge of bankruptcy. Officially brought on as an advisor following the Next purchase, Jobs started taking the lead at Apple again. Under Jobs, Apple continued its resurgence, seeing healthier profits and stock prices. Apple returned to profitability under the Think Different campaign as the iMac was launched in 1998. In 1999, Apple's profits doubled to $601 million, a 94% increase from the year prior. Jobs finally became CEO of Apple in 2000. The retail chain of Apple stores were opened in 2001, and a few months later, the iPod and iTunes were announced. These two were the first of many products to turn Apple into the biggest company in the world, though the company's most important product remains the iPhone, which got its first version released in June 2007. In 2011, Jobs resigned as CEO due to health complications, and Tim Cook became the new CEO. 2 months later, Jobs died. Apple currently has a revenue of $265 billion, and it is the world's largest technology company by revenue and also the most valuable company in the world, at a current market capitalization of $2 trillion. It is also the world's third largest mobile phone manufacturer after Samsung and Huawei, who sell more phones but at much smaller premiums. In August 2018, Apple became the first publicly traded company to be valued at over $1 trillion, and just 2 years later, in August 2020, became became the first $2 trillion US company. It operates the iTunes Store, which is the world's largest music retailer. As of January 2020, more than 1.5 billion Apple products are actively being used worldwide. Furthermore, Apple has an extremely high level of brand loyalty, which might even be its biggest asset. This is also the reason why the firm is ranked as the world's most valuable brand. Some of you might not have known that Apple was on the verge of bankruptcy in the past. As you can see, it is possible to turn around a seemingly hopeless situation if you have a good idea for the future and work hard to implement it. Let that inspire you. Thank you for watching our video. If you liked it, please don't forget to subscribe and push the bell button. We will keep uploading educating and interesting videos about the world's richest people and companies. Let us know in the comments about your favorite Apple fact. Did we miss anything? Also, feel free to tell us in the comments about your ideas for our next videos. The world of business is vast and allows for a large number of lessons, so let us know what's interesting to you.